This video is sponsored by Squarespace. Hi all, in today's video I will show you a few plants that I own that look really great on tabletops and on small tables. And these plants generally are very compact and they don't grow to be very big. So they're a good choice if you're looking to decorate your tabletops. Before I get into the video, I would quickly like to remind you to participate in our monthly giveaways. And this month's giveaway has been sponsored by The Beige Bag. They have sponsored a lovely set of planters and a rug as well. So be sure to participate. The rules will be all in the description down below, and give it a shot. So let's get started. The first set of plants that I will recommend are right here on this table, and I will start with this one. This is commonly called the Aralia, but the scientific name is Polyseus guilfoliae. And we will not call it by its scientific name, we'll stick to the common name. Now, we know this Aralia plant, they are compact. We get variants of these plants that are compact and that remain smaller. There are plants that grow really tall and big as well. But today we will talk about these dwarf, these tiny versions that remain small and look really pretty on tables. I've had this one for a very long time now. It has remained like this. It has probably not grown because of the lack of light. It doesn't get as much light that it needs, but it's thriving. It's looking good and it is growing well. It needs to be watered and misted. It cannot be left dry. So if you leave it dry, it will start getting very scraggly and it will look very bad. So if you want it to look full, fresh and as pretty, you have to keep misting it, watering it regularly. Now these plants look really pretty in white pots, especially because of the way the leaves are. They're very tiny and they're very delicate, and they have a lot of variegation white on them, which makes it look very, very pretty. The next set of plants are Phytonias, the Phytonia albivenis. These plants are commonly called the nerve plant, and these plants are excellent because they look really pretty on tabletops. They remain compact, they remain small, and they grow like this rather than growing tall. The foliage on these are so beautiful. You get red veined ones, pink veined ones, bright red, bright green with a bright red. So there are many different variants to choose from, and sometimes the leaves shape also vary. Like the one here has broad flat leaves and the one next to it is smaller pointed. So there is a lot to choose from. There's a lot of variety to choose from. I always keep Phytonias, though they are among the fussy plants and they are very difficult to keep alive. I myself have killed quite a few Phytonias, but do not leave them thirsty and keep the humidity high up for them and give them enough light. That's how they will survive. If you want to know in detail how to take care of your Phytonias, check out my plant table video on Phytonias. I will leave it in the description down below. The third set of plant that I would recommend are Tillandsias, Tillandsia iononantha especially. They are the most common Tillandsias and the most easy to care for. Of course, there are many more Tillandsias to choose from, but I would right now recommend these plants as easy to keep. The one over here is the Druid and this one is the normal iononantha. This one blooms purple and red like all the common iononanthas, and this one, the plant blushes a lemon green and the blooms are white with the Druid. These are beautiful plants to keep, very easy to keep because they don't need any soil, they don't have any pest problems, just that you have to keep them in a place where it is not soggy and not too wet. So I keep them on this aquarium rock which has enough holes, and it is growing very happy on these rocks. It has flowered, it has given a lot of pups, and I'm really happy with this plant. So this plant is, again, if you keep them displayed like this, you can display them so beautifully on your tabletops. You can display them on pieces of wood log also. So they look really nice on driftwood as well. The next plants that I would recommend are the Peperomia caperata. So the caperata, again, is an extremely fussy plant, and I myself have not been able to keep one alive for above a year. It stays with me for the longest time, for a lot of months, and then in the summers it generally doesn't survive because of the heat, and it just can't take the heat. So I've yet to be successful in keeping this alive for more than a year. But I have heard of many gardeners who have kept these alive in terrariums. So they do recommend, some of them have recommended to me that these will grow really well in terrariums. And I'm yet to try this out. So probably this year, after the winters are done, I will put these plants, or maybe in the winters itself, I will put them both in a terrarium and see if it works and if I can keep them alive. But for now, they look amazing on tabletop. So I do display them on my tables whenever I entertain people. So it's a very pretty looking plant. And the reason that they look good on tables is because of the round form, the way the leaves grow. And you get them in colors and the leaves have different variations, which makes it look so beautiful. This one, I think, goes by many names. I'm not sure which it is exactly, but based on the color, it's probably the Shumi Red, the Ruby. I'm not sure, but this one is the green one, the Green Emerald. So you get them in different colors. You get variegated ones too. So these are not very expensive. They are cheap. You get them within 100 rupees. And even if they die on you in a couple of months, it doesn't pinch your pocket as much as an expensive plant would. So even though I'm struggling with keeping these alive, still trying to master their care, I would recommend these as very pretty tabletop plants. The next plants I recommend are the Tradescantias, the Tradescantia albiflora and the Zebrina. I would recommend the albiflora to be a little more compact compared to the Zebrina. Zebrinas tend to grow lanky, long, and in hanging baskets. These are plants for hanging baskets more than tabletops. But I do include them in this video for one reason, is you can keep them compact if you want to. You can keep plucking and poking them back into the soil and keep pruning them in such a way to keep them compact. So they grow well in hanging baskets. I would say they are better for hanging baskets, but they also look good on tabletops. You can groom them in a way to keep their form and shape so that they look good on tabletops and as compact plants. There are many Tradescantias to choose from, so I have kept these two here right now, but there are many varieties that you can pick and choose from, and you can keep them looking compact and cute. The next set of compact plants that I would recommend are Rex begonias, of course. These begonias grow shrub-like in small sizes, and they don't grow tall like cane begonias. And the leaves are exceptionally beautiful. The foliage is incredible. They come in different colors and silver splashes. And I can't describe the beauty of it. You can see it for yourself. This one is the Rex begonia Fedor, and this one is the Voodoo Star. So both these begonias have incredible silvery leaves. Now, if you would have asked me some time back, maybe 3 months back or 4 months back, would you keep Rex begonias? I would say no, because I was not at all confident keeping them. But now slowly I've begun to understand how these plants react and how these plants behave and what it takes to keep them happy. So I'm a little more successful with Rex begonias, and I would definitely say that they are a plant that I would choose now. I would pick Rex begonias for my home. I've always loved them. I've always admired how beautiful they are, but have been struggling to keep them happy. And now I have discovered the secret, and I am slowly keeping more and more Rexes. The leaves, again, are incredible, beautiful. And they look really good on table setups and for your dining table or for your coffee table. They look really beautiful. Just that you need to give them bright light and you need to keep them well watered in a perfect substrate that will keep them happy. So this is a plant that I would highly recommend. But if you are not confident keeping Rexes and you've not had success in the past, do your research and buy one Rex at a time. Try to keep one Rex happy and going, and then only invest in another one when you know that you are confident that you will keep the plant happy. So if you're willing to take a little extra effort to keep them happy, they make for beautiful decor pieces, I would say. The next plant is the Dracaena trifasciata, the dwarfs. So you get these compact ones. They were previously known as the Sansevieras, or commonly called a snake plant. So we can call them the snake plant for now. So the snake plant is a great plant to keep. You get dwarf varieties like the Hyene and trifasciata dwarfs. So these grow small. They don't grow really tall and they remain compact. They look good solo in the middle of a coffee table. I always love this look. And they are excellent plants that do okay in shade as well. So if you don't give them light for some time, they will tolerate it. But don't think that these plants can survive without light. They do need light to survive. So bright light is what they appreciate and they will grow and thrive in. Try to give them bright light and these plants will be happy. As for the look of it and the form of it, I really enjoy how Sansevieras look, how snake plants look. They are gorgeous and now you get so many varieties, so many variants that you can choose and pick what suits your taste, what you like and what looks good in your home. So this is another good choice that you can make. Another plant that wouldn't be on the top of my list for tabletop plants. This is a plant that grows beautifully in hanging baskets. This is an Episcia. But when I take cuttings of Episcias, I put them in smaller pots and I grow the cuttings this way. And when they are small, they look really pretty in a small pot or on the table. So I do, I would add this to the list for that reason. So the smaller plants can definitely be displayed like this. And if you want to keep it compact, always keep plucking and keep pruning it and grooming it and keeping it in that shape to make it look small and compact for your spaces. This one is the Peperomia orba. So I've been talking about a lot of Peperomias here. The Peperomia orba is one of the hardier Peperomias. This plant has been with me for a very long time. And unlike the Russo or unlike the Caprata, they are not as fussy. But yes, they don't like to be overwatered. If you overwater them, it will die out. And they don't like too much heat and temperatures that go very high or low. So you have to be a little careful with them. Now, this plant has an excellent form. You look at the leaves, they are all so succulent-like and they are so glossy and beautiful. And also, the form remains like this. It's a very beautiful plant. It's slow-growing and I would recommend this for tabletops. They look really lovely in the center of a table and they have a presence and the green lushness of it itself attracts me a lot. There are many more variants in this one. There's a pixie lime also, which is another pretty plant. The leaves are exactly the same shape, but it's a more lemon limey with a little bit of variegation. And that also is an excellent plant to get for your tabletop displays. Also, I would recommend the Russo. Again, it's a Peperomia. So these Peperomia plants are all compact and all very cute looking. So they look really good on your tabletops. Since I'm talking about Peperomia so much, I will also recommend the Peperomia optocifolia or calcifolia. And they also are excellent. They are more hardy, definitely more hardy, and they are still beautiful plants. And they will look good on tabletop displays. Running an e-commerce store is not easy. There are a million things to set up when you are starting out. Brand building, products, vendors, taxation website, photo shoot, packaging, shipping. The list is never ending. It really takes the load off you when you have the right partner. This brings me to Squarespace, a power platform where you can create and host your website and your web store. At Squarespace, you can build a community with a fully integrated commenting system. This is a wonderful way to connect with your audience and at the same time generate revenue through gated members-only content that you provide on your website. With Squarespace extensions, you can manage your inventory, promote products, and ship them across the globe, all within one easy-to-use platform. So if you are planning to launch your own small business, go to squarespace.com for a free trial to get a feel of the platform. And when you are ready to launch, go to squarespace.com/geeksofgreen to save 10% on your first purchase of a website or a domain. I really hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, do give us a thumbs up, and it takes you a moment to hit the like button, but it helps our channel so very greatly. So please take a moment, hit that like button and help us out here. And also subscribe to this channel if you haven't subscribed yet and you like green content. And I hope to see you soon in another video. Till then, stay green.